Hey, what's up everyone? This is Free For All Friday. I'm Vince Del Monte. Today we're going to be answering your questions. So I asked my Facebook fan page fans, you know, what's on your mind? What can I help you with? And a lot of you guys need help with sleep, longer sleep. How do I get into a better quality sleep? What are some sleep strategies? So I want to share with you guys some great sleep strategies to improve your quality of sleep. This is a great topic because it's a very important topic because you will die of sleep deprivation before you die of starvation. That's how important sleep is. It affects everything. And when you don't get sleep, as you probably know, you become a very unhappy, a very angry, a very hungry. You become a very ineffective person. So sleep is so, so important for each and every one of us. So let's start off with some simple strategies to improve your sleep. We'll start with supplements because that's a super easy one. So one supplement that you need to take if you're having a hard time with sleep is vitamin D3. All right, vitamin D3, there's a very high number of receptor sites for vitamin D3 in the part of the brain that controls your sleep-wake cycle. All right, so if you're deficient in vitamin D3, you're gonna have a hard time sleeping. And there's been a lot of research to show how vitamin D3 supplementation can lead to better sleep over time, okay? I believe the amount you want to strive for at a blood level is 60 to 80 nanograms per milliliter of blood. So that's something you can figure out through blood work. But once you get into that 60 to 80 range, you're going to do really well. And a good dosage, most people, the research has shown that around 4,000 to 5,000 IU a day of vitamin 3 will start moving you into that range, okay? So start with vitamin D3. That's a huge place to start. Another supplement you want to take a look at is taurine. Taurine is a really powerful nutrient which helps increase GABA, which helps with calming the nervous system and getting you to relax and to kind of just basically chill out. So when you increase taurine levels, which are very high in foods like seafood, eggs, meat, you're gonna get a good amount of taurine, but if you're still not sleeping well, you may wanna supplement with taurine. That's been shown. So, you know, a lot of vegetarians have a hard time getting those, have a hard time sleeping because they don't get those kind of foods in their diet. So if you're a vegetarian, you definitely wanna be supplementing with taurine. Another little tip is to utilize carbohydrates at the end of the day. So carbohydrates are kind of like a sleep aid. Different foods stimulate different chemical pathways in your body. So we know a diet higher in proteins and fats are not gonna make you as sleepy as a diet that's higher in carbohydrates. So we can use that to our advantage. So another great way to increase sleep quality is to ensure your diet is comprised of primarily proteins and fats. And then if you're having trouble sleeping, you can introduce some carbohydrates near the end of the day. Now, whether they're high glycemic or low glycemic is debatable. There's people that certain people respond differently to different times of carbs. Some people, if they have a lot of sugary carbs before they go to bed, like, you know, ice cream, cookies, things like that, they can't sleep. They'll wake up within an hour. Some people, that's actually just right for them. So it is an individual thing, but carbohydrates within an hour or two before you go to bed can help you sleep better. Last thing, you want to kind of get into an unwind mode near the end of the day. So, you know, start chilling out, you know, close the laptop, get off of Facebook, stop looking at email, stop looking at stimulating things that can, you know, create a lot of electricity, so to speak, to the brain, and then, you know, can get your brain in overdrive and, you know, getting anxious and thinking about other things. So, you know, a little tip is to read a half an hour before you go to bed. If you can read a half an hour before you go to bed every night, that's really gonna help you just chill out, let your nervous system calm down, whatever was going on during the day, let those things kind of fall to the wayside and just start to unwind, okay? So close the laptop, get off of social media, turn the TV off for at least an hour or so before you go to bed and just chill out, read, talk with your spouse, just meditate, write in a journal, do something that's just totally chilling to you. And then my final tip is just to start going to bed earlier. There's been a lot of great research that shows that for every hour of sleep you get before midnight, it's the equivalent of 2 hours sleep, okay? If you haven't tried this before, man, you're totally missing out. This is one of my favorite, you know, strategies. So if you go to bed at 11 o'clock, you know, that hour between 11 and 12 is actually the equivalent of 2 hours sleep. At least that's what it's gonna feel like, all right? So the earlier you can go to bed, the easier it'll be to wake up earlier and more well-rested. You can get a jump on the day ahead of everybody else. You can get things done while the rest of the world is sleeping, all right? You can really, really achieve a lot of great things in your life simply by going to bed earlier and getting better quality sleep. So start training yourself. I started going to bed at 9:30. It's probably the best decision I've ever made for my health, for my physique, for my productivity. The earlier you can go to bed, the better. You're gonna be forced to wake up earlier. You won't need an alarm clock because your body will wake you up naturally. So start pulling back that time you go to bed. It's gonna require some lifestyle changes, but trust me, it's well worth it, all right? Nothing really good happens after 10 o'clock anyways. Typically, that's just when you get into trouble, when you start staying up late on your computer, doing who knows what, going out with friends late at night. You know, sure, every once in a while, but nothing really good happens after 10 o'clock anyways. At least that's what my father always told me, and I'm starting to believe that too now as a new dad. So hope you guys found those tips helpful. Lots more things that you guys can do, but start there. Those are 5 great tips to improve your sleep quality. Over and out. Be sure to like this vid and subscribe to the channel if you want to keep getting more and more videos. That's how you can communicate with me, letting me know that you like this stuff. All right, see you soon.